ನಮಸ್ತೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಕಲಾಂಶುವಿನ ಹೊಸ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಸರಣಿ ಆನೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಲಾಂಶು, ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ದಿನ ಇದ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ ಕೆಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಲಾಂಶುವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಗೀತದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವಿತ್ತು, ಫುಟ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಲಾಂಶುವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನೃತ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳಿತ್ತು. ಹಾಗೆ ಆನೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಲಾಂಶು ಈ ಒಂದು ಸರಣಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತುಗಾರಿಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಚರ್ಚೆಗಳಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಹೀಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಸರಣಿಯನ್ನ ರೂಪಿಸಲಾಗಿದೆ. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆನೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಲಾಂಶು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆದರದ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಈ ದಿನ ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ಆನೊಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಲಾಂಶು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ವಿದ್ವಾನ್ ಮನ್ನಾರ್ ಕೋಯಲ್ ಜೆ ಬಾಲಾಜಿ ಸರ್ ಅವರು. ಇವರು ಈ ದಿನದ ಒಂದು ವಿಷಯ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜತೀಸ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರೀಯ ಮತ್ತು ಆಮೂಲಾಗ್ರವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಸಂಗೀತದಲ್ಲಿ ತಾಳದ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಮುಖ್ಯತೆಯ ವಿಚಾರವಾಗಿ ಈ ದಿನ ಒಂದು ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ದಿನದ ವಿಷಯ ನಾನು ಆಗ್ಲೇ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಜತೀಸ್. ಸೊ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಆಲ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ of program called Annotations at Kalamshu. So far you've been witnessing Cadenza at Kalamshu, which was a musical Facebook live series. Then we had Footnotes at Kalamshu, which was a dance series. Now we have Annotations at Kalamshu, which covers predominantly the talk based program, which could include lectures, discussions and interviews. Today the program is going to be started off or inaugurated by Vidwan Mannar Koyal J. Balaji sir, who is going to talk on the topic development of jatis. And this is going to be more or less a 1 hour program. Please post in any doubts that you have about the program, in the sense because this is a lecture program, so any clarifications that you require, you could just post it as comments. We shall take it to the speaker as and when the comments are available to us. We also keep the stage open towards the end of the program for any more doubt clarifications. Please do post in your lectures and your feedback about the program as the program is going live. Now, introducing the artist of the day, Vidwan Mannar Koyal J. Balaji sir is an amalgamation or a blend of two traditions, Tanjore tradition and Pudukkottai tradition of Mridangam. So he was groomed under Tanjore Shri S. Ramadas and Ramanathapuram Shri M.N. Kandaswamy. He has been featured in major concerts since 1983 and he's been appearing in Chennai December music season since 1984 without a break. The number of concerts in the vast span runs to more than 4,000 concerts, and his style is a blend of highly enhanced aesthetic accompaniment coupled with remarkable technical precision. He has toured extensively all over India and abroad. He took part in the world famous 13th Asia Pacific Festival in Japan, prestigious Estin concert Tallinn, Estonia, and for exclusive rhythm workshop at Johannesburg and Durban, South Africa. Hong Kong Cultural Center invited Sangeetha Kalanidhi Srimati Manikrishna Swami to perform at Hong Kong, where his accompaniment showed a great promise and high caliber. He has also visited countries like United States of America, Canada, Malaysia, Singapore, New Zealand, and Australia, along with the artists of high repute. He gave a special training to the students at Leeds University in UK for their SAA annual festival. He has played Jugalbandi concerts with Pandit Ajay Chakraborty and Pandit Hari Prasad Chaurasia. He has conducted lecture demonstrations on various aspects of rhythm, demystifying its various aspects in easy and simple methods. Primer on Layam is a special DVD made out of live lecture demonstration, explains the nuances of South Indian rhythm, addressing to both layman and the learned. He is an A grade artist of All India Radio and Doordarshan, having been featured in various programs, including National Program of Music and CPC Central Government Archives. The awards received by him include Best Junior Mridangist in 1989, Best Accompanist in 1999, and Palani Subramanya Pillai Award for Best Mridangist in 2007 by Music Academy Chennai. He is an Asthana Vidwan of Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham and was awarded Meritorious Award for Excellence by Maharajapura Santhanam Foundation. He was awarded Layakala Vipanchi by Vipanchi Organization on 31st December 2010. He received the Award of Excellence by Kartik Fine Arts on 14th April 2014, Guru Karaikudi Mani Award for Excellence in December 2014. During the year 2019, he was awarded by Tamil Nadu State Government and also awarded Vani Kala Nipuna by Tyaga Brahma Gana Sabha, Chennai. So we have this immensely talented and a very gifted speaker, Manar Koyal Ji Balaji sir with us, who's going to speak on development of jatis. Kindly note this program is going live both on YouTube as well as Facebook. So we shall follow your comments on both the places and pass it on to the speaker of the day, Vidwan Manar Koyal J. Balaji. And we are handing over the stage to the sir. Now it is Annotations at Kalamshu by Vidwan Manar Koyal J. Balaji.
Namaste, everyone. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. At first, I would like to thank Kalamshu Trust for giving me this wonderful opportunity. And I'm always happy to talk about Lyam. This is the core of my life. This is the core of my subject, and I have worked on this subject for the past 40 to 45 years. And recently, I've been giving a lot of, due to this lockdown, I've been giving a lot of lectures and workshops to various organizations through live on Facebook. And today, I'm really happy to be a part of Kalamshu Trust Bangalore. And I just now got to know that this is the first ever program. I am very happy and thankful to Kalamshu Trust for giving me this cap. And I wish you all the best in the coming years for more and more such fruitful lectures by artists of repute in various fields. Art as such gives one happiness and also provides us peace of mind, and it enhances one's being. It is the best medium, especially the classical side of arts is the best medium, because it is supposed to calm the senses more than ignite the senses. So whatever calms the senses is supposed to be the classical form of the art. Whatever ignites the senses is supposed to be the other forms. So I am very happy to be a part of this classical art, which not only calms the listeners, but also the performer. So both ways, we are all benefited by this exercise, and also during practices and during concerts, during our travel, we meet a lot of people. It gives us a lot of wide experiences to learn, to accumulate, and to disseminate. This is the actual process of with which one learns and also one performs. coming to the topic of the day, development of jatis. The origin of jatis can be traced to the Shiva Tandava, wherein we have all the syllables rolling down to the world of music through the dance form, through the musical forms, and all the other methods. As such, the rhythm is the foremost aspect of a music, which even preceded speech. You must have heard the earlier, the olden days people communicated through the method of drums. Various types of drum beats were used to convey the status that in which they were in. So even before the speech was formed, rhythm was available. So the syllables themselves, jatis or syllables or phrases, syllables are individual letters, and when you mix those letters, they become phrases. When you mix those phrases, that is words, when you mix those words, they become phrases, and then the phrase become a sentence and an essay and a whole idea of a Taniyavartanam, or a whole idea of the Layam gets formed inside the person. As I said, first is the syllable, then the word. Syllables are getting formed into words, words into phrases, phrases into sentences, into paragraphs, into an essay, and the whole thing gets from slowly to the bigger circle or world of Laya. Let us first get those technical details cleared. Many people ask me what is an akshara and a matra. That is one thing many people ask me. First, those doubts have to be cleared if you want to get into the laya aspects clearly. Practical, I am going to tell you only the practically common usage. Akshara is beat count. Any beat, number of beats, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. The number of beats, we call them aksharas. And the pulses inside them, takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka. The pulses inside them, we call them matras. In order to avoid this confusion, beats and pulses, we can use them. Beats are aksharas, pulses are matras. This is a simple way you can understand. And this is being commonly used, though this is not the definition given in the books. We are using it as the common terminology that is used in the practical, used for the practical purposes. Okay. I again tell you, this is not what is given in the literature. The literature says something else, which is beyond our lecture today. Whereas it is enough if you understand that aksharas as beats and matras as inside inner pulses. So if you go as takkit, 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 beats still remain 8, whereas the inner pulses going in 3. So the total count also will change. We will come to that in a little while from now. So the first things first, as I told you, aksharas and matras, or counts or pulses. That is the first thing you need to be clarified about. Second thing you need to be clarified about is the jati and jati. Jati is a syllable. Jatis are syllables, words. Okay. Jati. Jati means basically numbers. We have 5 jatis, that is Tisra, Chatushra, Kanda, Mishra, and Sankirna. We have 5 jatis, basically 5 jatis, but jatis means, please understand, they are numbers. Any number is a jati. If you say 2 also, it is a jati. 3 also jati. 6 also is a jati. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, any number is a jati, basically. Though they are not called jati, as far as the Tala is concerned, we will consider them as jatis because all of them represent numbers. So jati and jati. We learned first aksharas and matras. Second, the difference between jati and jati. Then between sol, kattu, konnakko. This is different. These are all the terms that we'll be learning now. Sol is jati. They are equivalent. Tamil word. Sol is a Tamil word. Jati is a Sanskrit word. Jati is equivalent to sol. Sol kattu is a bunch of syllables or a group of syllables. Kattu is a building up, building block. You can say a building block of syllables. Sol kattu. Konnakol. Konnakol is the art form. Art form. We don't say konnakol for oral renditions. The oral renditions used as an art form in a concert is called konnakol. So when I recite some jatis, it is sol kattu. When I recite the same jati to the accompaniment of a vocal or an instrument, then it is called konnakol. The art form of reciting jatis orally in a concert or in a performance is konnakol. So understand all these technical terms clearly before embarking into the lecture today. Unless you are clear, you will be held up in the confusion between the terms that I use later during the course of this lecture. So we will have to be clear about all of them. Akshara, Matra, Jati and Jati, Sol, Solkattu, Konnakol. So we will learn to them. Next, we will understand the Jatis as the numbers. I told you Jatis as numbers. They are basically five Jatis. Where the five Jatis are used, I will tell you just now. Five jatis are basically Tishra, Chaturasra, Kanda, Mishra and Sankirna. Tishra is three, Chaturasra is four, Chatusra or Chaturasra is four, Kanda is five, Mishra is seven and Sankirna is nine. But as personally, I consider all the numbers as jatis only. Six, which is a double of three, is also a jati. And 8, which is a double of 4, is also a jati. They have got names like your terms like your Tisra, Chatusra. They call it Divya Sankirna, something like that. These names are there. Don't get confused with the names. Just consider them all as numbers. Why I tell you particularly numbers is all formation of jatis at the foundation, they are all numbers only. Before we convert them into solkattu, before we convert them into syllables, matras, syllables, and then into the group of syllables, and then expand them slowly. So basically, if you don't have a number, you don't have anything at all. It is a vacuum. So without numbers, no work online. With numbers, we are having a first step into the realm of lion. So first numbers, 1 and 2, generally we don't take it up. For 1, we have a syllable called ta. Ta is a syllable for 1. Takka is for 2. Is 2. Takkitta is 3. Or tum tum ta is 3. 4. Takka dimmi. 5. Tatting Gennatum. 2 and 3 mix also you can get Takka and Takita. That is how you can develop the phrases slowly. See, 5 has got a combination of 2 and 3, 1 and 4, and then 3 and 2, and then 4 and 1, and then 5. So we will see all of them gradually when we proceed to the next step. Now only the introduction to the numbers and the corresponding jatis. So the five is tadvinginnattum is 5. 6 is is six. Or you can mix numbers, which I will tell you. Takkar takkar dimmi, 2 plus 4. Takkitta tum tum ta. So this is six. I will tell you how the development takes place in the intermediary level when I proceed with the lecture. Then comes takkitta takkar dimmi for 7. 7 also takes 2 and 5. Takkattadim vennattum. Takkittattakkadim. Takkadim mi takkitta. Takkadim mi tuntumta. So this is 7. Next comes 8. 8 is takkadim mi takkajannu. 8 is takkitta taddim vennatum, 3 and 5. Takkadim mi takkajannu, I told you already. Takkitta takkadim mi. Tum tum takkadim mi. So this is how you can develop the sulcata slowly. Then we come to 9. 9 is the basically takkadim mi taddim gennatum. Takkitta takkitta takkitta. Tum tum ta tum tum ta tum tum ta. Takkitta takkitta taddim gennatum. These are all for 9. This is not the exhaustive list. I am giving you only the introductory level. We will go to the advanced level as we proceed through the lecture. Next comes 10. Taddin ginnattum, taddin ginnattum. Takkadimmi, takkadimmi. Takkitta takkadimmi takkitta, 3 and 7. This is 3 and 7. So we saw numbers only up to what? From 1 to 10 only. You can go on expanding. I will tell you, for example, if you want to do for 13, you can do very easily 7 and 6. Takkadimmi takkitta taddim ginnattum. So if you mix the numbers, then you will get more syllables on your repertoire, rhythm repertoire. That is how slowly structures get built up. How the structures are getting built up is basic numbers, and then substitute them with syllables, and then try to transform them into something more than the syllable level. So that is where the art form starts. How it starts is, for example, let's take 7 as the example. 5 plus 2, 7. So I will just tell you a few of the examples of how 7 is getting developed. Ta, ki, ta, ta, ka, di, mi, tak, ki, ta, tak, ka, di, mi, tak, ki, ta, tak, ka, di, mi. Takkitta takkadimmi, takkitta takkadimmi, takkitta takkadimmi, tatum, tatum, tata. If you had observed, at the end I had done one small development of a short ending phrase, tatum, tatum, tatum. I have done it. I will tell you all of them as we proceed. Before doing that, we will now develop takkitta takkadimmi. We will develop. Takkitta takkadim. Takkattadim ginnattum. Tattadim ginnattum. Tattakkitta tumtumta. So these are all the possibilities. Takka timmi takkitta. Tattikkitta tum takka. Reverse also is possible. That is 7 minus 1 plus 1. That is one logic I would like to tell you. This is the concept-oriented learning you have to understand. If you understand the concept, it can be, they can be applied for any tala. So there is no restriction about the tala. There are only concepts. Some for 20, 50 concepts are there. You have to learn the concept. Then the application to the talas become very easy. So whenever you take a number, as I was telling you, 7 is the first number, minus 1 plus 1, minus 2 plus 2, all of them will be equal. 7 minus 2, 7 minus 2 is 5, so plus 2, 7, 5 plus 2 is 7. So like that, you can form all the combinations so that you develop your own sulcata base or repertoire. The phrases are very, very important, and the phrases, analyzing the phrases are very important. More than analyzing the phrases, you will also have to work on them. Listen to them and absorb, assimilate, produce. That is the process. So without observing and absorbing, nothing comes out. It will be a mystery only. As I told you, I'll be discussing the jatis. To recap, jati is a number. For any jati, we should do trikala exercise minimum for any number. As I told you, 1, 2, you can just omit. From 3 onwards until 10, you have to do trikala. Trikala means first speed once, second speed twice, third speed 4 times. I'll repeat. First speed once, second speed twice, and third speed 4 times. Why it is done is, in order to get a grip of both, there are two aspects you should understand. One is the aspect of the tala, that is a constant. It doesn't have a, it is a constant moving, it's a constantly moving thing. That is like a road. It's constantly on the, it's giving us a platform. Whereas our jatis are constantly on the move. So when we recite the jatis, the pace of the tala should never be altered. That is why I am saying the pace of the tala is constant. So whenever I say the pace of the tala, you should understand tala as a steady flow. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Even though I varied the speed of rendition of the jati called three, I didn't vary the speed of the tala. You should understand this point first. This is the most important point for a person willing to learn laya, willing to excel in laya, willing to do something in laya, willing to delve deep into the realm of laya. So this is the most basic thing you should all understand. So for trikala, what is the simplest formula you can have? The simplest formula is the number multiplied by 3 is the total number of counts, total number of aksharas you get. If you take tisra, tisra is 3, multiply by 3, you get 9 as the number. So if you want to do trikala for 3, 9 aksharas it will span. I will tell you. And how to count the tala in reverse. If it is 8, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we are going to talk about 9 aksharas, that is our 9 beats. So we have to start reverse counting from 16 onwards, 2 avartanas. 16, 15, 14, 13, 12. 10, 11, 10, 9. That is the ninth beat from where you should start trikala for tisra. What is the sulcata for tisra? Takita. Takita once in first speed, twice in second speed, 4 times in third speed, from the ninth spot, you get it. This is as simple as that. 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. Ta, ti, ta, tak, it, 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 ta, tak. For 4, now you must have guessed 4 into 3, 12. 12 beats for Chatusra, Jati, Trikala. 16, 15, 14, 13. Takadimi, 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 takadimi. So this is for 4. You must have guessed for all the other numbers also, but I will do it as an exercise so that for those who don't understand, will understand at a later stage also. For 5, 5 into 3, 15. 15 aksharas, that is 15 counts for rendering Trikala of Kandajati. 16. Ta, ti, ji, na, tum. Tat, ting, gin, 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 na, tum. So this is the basic exercise that all of you have to do for all the talas, especially the Suladi Sapta talas and all those talas that are in vogue, right? Like our Adi Tala, Rupaka Tala, Misra Chapu Tala, Kanda Chapu Tala, Kanda Triputra Tala, Misra Jampa Tala, Kanda Jati Atta Tala, Tishra Triputra Tala. At least these 7, 8 talas, you should do the Trikala for all the jatis. I will take you to the next step in a short while after rendering the Trikala for now 5, 7 and 9. For 7, what is the 7 is Misra Jati. Trikala 7 into 3 multiplied, 7 multiplied by 3, we get a result of 21, which is the 21st beat. Come from 24, 3 into 8, 24, 24, 23, 22. This is the 21st beat. We start Trikala of Misra Jati from the 21st beat. 24, 23, 22. Ta, ti, ta, 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 ti, ni, tak, ki, ta, takadim, takita, takadimi, takita, takadimi, takita, takadimi, takita, takadimi, takita, takadimi, takita. This is for Misra Jati, 21 aksharas or 21 counts, and Misra Jati Trikala. Now we go to Sankirna Jati. Sankirnam is 9. Takadimi, tadinginatum. 9 is 9 into 3, 27 is the count. So we come back from 32. 32, 31, 30, 29, 28. Ta, ta, di, di, ta, di, di, na, tum. Takka, di, mi, ta, ting, di, na, tum. Takka, di, mi, ta, ting, di, na, tum. Takadimi, tadinginatum, takadimi, tadinginatum, takadimi, tadinginatum, takadimi, tadinginatum. So this is about the Jati Trikalam. Jatis of Tisra, Chatusra, Kanda, Misra, and Sankirna Trikalam. Any number, this is the rule. If you want to take 8, 3 into 8, 24, start from the summum. 24 is the summum point. So you can easily do it. Ti, ta, ta, di, di, na, tum. Takki, ta, ta, ting, 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 di, na, tum. This way, you first have to do Trikala for all the jatis. Not only 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, but all the numbers. From 3 to whatever number you want to do, you can do. The limit is, sky is the limit. You can do Trikala for any number. But basically what percussionists do is to do Trikala from 3 to 10. Keep them ready. This is not the, this is, but at a concert, before that I would like to tell you one thing. Trikala, the concept of Trikala goes like this. First speed, you have one syllable, that's the one jati per beat. Second speed, you have two syllables per beat. And the third speed, you have four syllables per beat. Four syllables per beat. So you should understand this before doing that. But anyway, you can do it for other jatis or other numbers as well. So you can try doing that at home for all the talas and all the jatis also. Generally, in a concert, what we do is, we don't do 1, 2, 4. We do only 1, 2, 3. That is first speed once, second speed twice, and third speed thrice only we do in a concert. See, when you say, ta, di, ki, na, tum, tat, ding, gin, nat, 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 tum, ta. So we do like that. For what is the jati I did? I did Kanda Jati, Trikala, that is first speed once, second speed twice, and third speed thrice. In order to find out the place, it is very easy. We did 1, 2, 4. In the third speed, remove one and then render the Trikala with 1, 2, 3. That is first speed once, second speed twice, and third speed thrice. I will tell you for Kanda Jati. I will tell you for Tisra Jati, Chatusra Jati, Kanda Jati, Misra Jati, and Sankirna Jati as well. How to do it? How very simple. But this becomes 1/4, 3/4 will be there. I will tell you about all of them now. That is, now for Kanda Jati, we have five. Five Trikala is Ta, Ti, Gi, Na, To, Tat, Ding, Gin, Nat, 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 To, Ta. This is for Kanda Jati Trikala, which is 15. 5 is 15. Aga, Gigi, Gigi, Aga, To, Tat, Ding, Gin, Nat, 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 To. This is Kanda Jati Trikala in the traditional way, that is 1, 2, and 4. Now we are going to do 1, 2, 3. What we have to do is remove the one time from the third speed. That is third thing, Girnatum in the third speed from the beginning. That is the 15th spot. 16, 15. Third thing, Girnatum. Ta, di, ki, na, tum. Third thing, Girnatum. 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 This is quite challenging. This has to be worked out and this has to be done. Because our line is not all about doing in samam or half. The line goes well only in 1/4 and 3/4 spaces. For all of them, you have to work out. I'll tell once again. Tat ting gin nat tum ta ti ti na tum tat ting gin nat 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 tum. For all the numbers, you have to do. If you take 3, from the 9th spot, leave 1, 3. That is 3 by 4. 3 pulses you leave. And then do the Trikala. Takkitta, tara, kiwi, tara. Takkitta, 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 ta. Then takkadimi. Ta, ta, di, di. Takkadimi, takkajan. Takkadimi, takkajadu, takkadimi, ta. Tadinganatam, I told you now. Tadinganatam, 21. So this is the 21st spot. Tat ting gin nat tum ta ki ta ta ka di mi tat ki ta tat 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 ka di mi. This could pose a challenge. This is how you develop the jatis and you develop the exercises for the jatis also. In this, I will tell you how to develop the jatis in the next section after doing this Trikala. Next, this comes, then the 9 comes. 9 is 27. So from this is the 27th point. Takka dimmi, ta dikita, ta, ta, ka, di, mi, ta, di, ki, na, tum. Takka dimmi, ta, di, gin, na, tum. Takka dimmi. So slowly you should start improvising within the Trikala themselves. as I did now for nine. I did for nine. Takita, 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 ta. All the three you can improvise now. I will show you how to do it. Ta, ta, ti, mi, ta, ti, ti, na, tum. Takka, tim, mi, ta, tim, tim, na, tum. Takka, tim, ta, tim, tim, na, tum. Takita, ta, tim, tim, na, tum. Takita, 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 takka, ta, tim, tim, na, tum. All of them improvise now. How the seven was taken as three and six, and then three, 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 and then two and seven. This is a random development only. I did not follow any logic, but I just tried to do a development. So this is how it can easily and logical, because when it comes to numbers and mathematics, it has to be logical. Then you go to the process of converting them into artistic expressions. Then you have to find ways to make it aesthetic and appealing. These are all the four steps for mathematics, basically the numbers, and then logic. You get the logical expressions for them, that is the mnemonics, and then we make them presentable, make them do a lot of exercises, make improvisations on them, and then you have to perform them as to appealing to the audience. That is the stage of aesthetic. These are all the four stages that you can develop through a process of scientific learning, and then go to the advanced level of aesthetics. So now I am going to tell you about how to develop this into other talas as well. The same thing, same logic. I'm going to take Mishra Chapu, which is the major tala. Mishra Chapu, I'm going to render the Trikala there itself. So Trikala of, we can take any number and then start counting from the reverse. That's all. Seven. For one avartana, for two avartanas, you take it as seven. For four avartanas, four cycles, you take it as 14. Multiplying. Easy, very easy. So for 20, you can take it from 21, 21, 15, okay, we can take 15 now, 21, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 13, in the same way, you can do 1, 2, 3 also. From the 15th spot, leave 1, 5, and then do first speed one, second speed twice, and third speed thrice. Taga, tiri, tiri, naga, togo, tati, kim, na, to, tati, kim, na, to, tati, kita, to, tati, kita, to, tati, kita, to. Same way you should be able to do for all the jatis. All the numbers should be made into Trikala. All the numbers should be made into Trikala with 1, 2, 3. First you do 1, 2, 4, and then analyze, write down, and then do 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 could pose a challenge because 3, 5, 7, 9, 4 numbers are odd numbers in that. In the series of Jati, 4 is the only even number. Other numbers are odd numbers. 3, 5, 7, 9 are odd numbers. So all of them will take you to 1/4 place or 3/4 place. So they will be very, very, very challenging. Unless you work with them, it is very difficult to get it. So this is about the jati, and the development of jatis into different talas. Next, we have to learn one more term, which is called gati. Gati is the speed of rendition. That is the internal pulses. Subdivision is there. I told you about the pulses, no? They are called subdivisions. If you say 4, it is a subdivision of 4. Subdivision. 4 is a chatusra gati. If there is a 3 subdivision, then it is a tisra gati. If it is a 5 subdivision, I will give you examples shortly. If it is a 5 subdivision, then it is Kanda Gati. If it is seven subdivision, then it is Misra Gati. Then it is, if it is a nine subdivision per beat, then it is a Sankirna Gati. Gati is the speed of rendition. So now you have learned so many terms, Aksharas, Matras, Sol, Chati, Chati, Solkat, Konakol, and now Gati. Gati is the latest. Gati means Tisragati, Chatusragati, Kandagati, Misragati, Sankirnagati. So the internal subdivisions are called Gati. So very simple. So when you say taktitta, 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 so in this, how will you count? Taktitta, taktitta. In this, how will you count? This is 8 into 3, 24. Taktitta, 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 taktitta. In this, it is 8 into 3, 24. How will you count? You can't count 20, 19, 18. So 8, 7, it will still be 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That is a clue. Whenever a number comes, okay, first observe clearly my words. Whenever a number comes, from that number, any number, if you say 15, or if you say, let us take a smaller number, 8, 7, if you say 7, it means that the jati for 7 from this part is once in first speed, twice in second speed, four times in third speed, three times in Tisragati, five times in Kandagati, seven times in Misragati, and nine times in Sankirnagati. That is the rule. What one place, the eight, ta, ti, ta, 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 ti, ti, ta. One time in first speed. Second speed, don't confuse the earlier exercise with this one. This is a different concept. That is a different concept. That is a concept I gave you for Trikala, mixing all of them. First speed, second speed, and third speed. This is, I'm giving you another concept where whatever the number itself gives us a clue to what is available to reach the summum. If it is seven, you can know that four sevens are there in third speed. Taka dimmi, takita, taka dimmi, takita, taka dimmi, takita, taka dimmi, takita, taka. 8, 7, 6, 5. Four fives are there from this part. Tadin dinnatam, tadin dinnatam, taka takita, tadin dinnatam. That's what it means. From the same spot, you have different expressions. This what is meant by this. Don't confuse, again I'm telling you, don't confuse the earlier exercise, this one. This is a different concept. Any number, what does it signify? In a tala, that's what I am telling you now. Earlier, what I thought was a trikala. That is a different. Just set that aside now and come to this now. Six, what does six represent? That a number alone, six represents that the jati, the sol or solkattu for six will be once in first speed from that spot. Ta, ta. Ta, ta, di, ni, ta. This is also not tala specific. If you say 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I will do Kanda Jati third speed from the fifth spot four times. 7, 6, tati, jinnatum, tati, jinnatum, tati, jinnatum, tati, jinnatum, ta. Any tala you take, this is the rule. Whatever number that finger count says, finger count or drita or any of the kriyas say, kriya is an action. That number is once from that point in first speed, twice from that point in second speed, four times from that point in third speed, thrice in Trisra, five times in Kanda, seven times in Misra, nine times in Sankirna. I'll give you a simple example of Tatinginatum, 7, 6, Tatinginatum, 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 Tatinginatum. This is in third speed. I'll come back to first speed and second speed and then third speed. First speed now, 8, 7, boom. Then second speed. 8, 7, 6. Tat din din nat boom. Tat din din nat boom. Third speed now. 7, 6. Tat din din nat boom. 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 Then now sistram is 3 times from the same spot. 8, 7, 6. Tat din din nat boom. Tat din din nat boom. Tat din din nat boom. Kandam 5 times. 7, 6. Mitra will be 7 times from the same spot. Same duration, but the number will be different for different gatis. That's what I wanted to tell you now. In Sankirna Gati, it will be 9 times. This very simple logic only, simple mathematics, simple logic. So this is how you develop jatis one by one by breaking down them into numbers and also by breaking them into subdivisions. So subdivisions also is possible. For example, if you take a number like a 9, 9 has got a combination of nearly about 256 combinations are possible within 9 itself. Not only this, you can split into 3, you can split into 4 times, you can split into 5 times, 6 times, 7 times, 8 times, 9 times. You can split any number of times and try to find that is also 9. That is 2, 3, 2, 2. That is also one of four breaks in 9. This is how slowly you can keep on developing talas, but how to place them in the talas is very important. That's what I taught you so far. And then I also taught you about gatis. Gatis also same calculation. This is the Chatusra Trikala of Chatusra Jati Trikala in Misra Gati, in Tisra Gati Adikala. How it is getting slowly complicated, you know. So that is how, that is the beauty of this Laya. Now I will render Trikala of Kanda Jati in Tisra Gati Adikala. Tum, ta, sorry, ta, di, di, na, tum, 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 ta, di, di, na, tum. You have to do this 1, 2, 3 also in Tisra Gati. That is also possible. Ta, di, 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 na, ta. This is how you can do for all varieties of jatis. Slowly develop from the basic, always. It is all, don't be afraid. It is all basic mathematics only, basic addition, basic multiplication. If you go from the numbers to jatis and then to the solkattu and then words, phrases, sentences, essays, then it will be easier. If you directly come back from essay, it will be very difficult for you to learn. I think most of the topics that I wanted to talk about development of jatis I have covered. If any questions are there, I think I welcome Kalamshu or any participant to ask me questions. I think I'm closing this lecture now. If any questions are there, I'm most willing to answer. Thank you, Kalamshu, over to you.
Thank you, sir. It was a very, 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 very enlightening exposition. I see a lot of audience actually liking it. Specifically, your comments were like, it was appealing not just to the practitioners, also to the layman. And we have seen this before. For a lot of people, your magic of teaching is actually getting introduced for the first time. We are so glad to have you. And it was so very well done. Again, I don't. It was so very well done.
Thank you.
We saw a lot of arithmetic in the process. Does it come because you work in Reserve Bank of India, or is it like?
No. Actually, see. To tell you frankly, I was very poor in mathematics. Really tell you, I got very poor marks in mathematics in 10th and 12th. Very frankly, I will tell you. But this acumen I got. That is why I am telling you. It is not mathematics in the real sense of like a calculus or a trigonometry or anything. No, no. Basic arithmetic. That is what I wanted to impress upon due to, through this program. Basic 2 plus 4, 6. How are you going to develop it? You have to take that exercise. You have to undergo that exercise. First of all, learning music requires a lot of patience. People leave it midway. Those who leave it midway are... They are not able to sustain. They are neither able to sustain the interest nor have the patience to pursue. So once one person has the patience to pursue, then they can learn very easily. Especially lyre requires a lot of patience, lot of working out. It will give you a lot of failures, but you should have to go over and above again and again. That's it. That's got nothing to do with mathematics. I was a failure in maths.
No, sir. But as I said, I mean, probably that journey which you have taken to really overcome that fear or that obstacle as, you know, made you go through so many paths which you are taking us through, and it is making our life easy to understand that.
Yes. That is my aim also. That is my aim also. Actually, see, if one has undergone the process of trouble, it doesn't mean that everyone has to undergo that same trouble. Why? Not required. So, especially in terms of art, that was the I would say, a secrecy maintained so far.
Yeah.
It's not required. I don't think secrecy should be maintained for an earnest learner. It should be disseminated. It should be given. That is my foremost idea.
Yes.
That is the reason why I go all out to teach people who come to me. But one thing I would like to tell you that you should require patience.
Yes, sir. Patience is the key. And as you said, it's not like people just go on the stage and start off doing the combination of things. You need to write, practice, and then work out. Then, as you said, the aesthetics part of it comes in only certain matras, not every matra, every combination gives the aesthetics. You need to try out things. Then you present it.
You have to practice. You have to practice 100 times. 100 times, 200 times, 1,000 times. Any exercise that you practice, you have to practice 100 times. It doesn't come overnight.
Because people have this perception that, I mean, this person actually is doing impromptu, and a lot of people get scared to really try out things. But
impromptu,
what you said was wonderful.
Impromptu is possible when you have the larger picture.
Yes.
If you don't have a larger picture, impromptu is not possible.
True.
So in order to go through the vigors and rigors of learning, you have to be patient. Then you slowly, as I developed it slowly to the bigger circle, see, it is a small circle, bigger circle, bigger circle. You have to expand your circle. The more you expand your circle, the more combination. I also, as an example, I would say that if you sing a Todi Raga, assume Todi Raga has got 25,000 Sangatis so far found. Assume. This is only a hypothetical situation,
okay.
I'm telling you.
Okay.
Assume you have 25,000 Sangatis, that is combinations, 25,000 combinations that are more famous in the the entire world of Carnatic music, assume. So a person knowing 1,000 will be working with those 1,000 combinations. A person knowing 20,000, a person knowing all the 25,000, that is the difference. So that is where you can mix the 900th phrase with the 19,999th phrase. A person who is knowing 1,000 will not know 19,999th phrase, right?
Yes, yes.
That is how the impromptu works. The jnana, the knowledge, not the knowledge is a very loose term to use. The jnana gives you that impromptu activity, not anything else. The practice combined with jnana, practice with patience. How far you are able to practice. Same, the repetitive practice is the only key to the success. Repetitive practice. You should not be bored with yourself, first of all.
Yes.
Doing the same thing. Todi is one raga. Kalyan is one raga. So you have to keep on practicing. Same thing, yes, again and again. That gives,
sir,
you that impromptu.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, there is one of the disciples. She has maybe few questions or one or two questions. I'd like to invite Kumari Ankita Bharadwaj online. And later there are a couple of more questions. I'll try to ask you later, sir.
Sure.
Ankita, over to you.
Sir, why should all the jatis should be odd numbers? Only four.
No, actually that is an interesting question. Four is called the international. That is the universal rhythm. So that is why for every musical form, four is the basic number. That is why they have included four also in the jati, not six or eight or ten. Basically, jatis we have included four odd numbers and only one even number. That even number is also universal rhythm four. You understand? Four is the universal rhythm. Takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takka jannu. Anybody will be able to easily follow. Tak, 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 tap, clap, or anything they will be able to do it. Takkitta, 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 tadikkitta, tadikkitta. If I say, people will not be able to follow. Takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takkitta, takkitta, takka dimmi, takka jannu, takka dimmi, takka. Unless I put the tala, people will not be able to follow. Whereas, if I play, they will be able to follow. Tachanutta, 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 talang. Automatically, your head will roll. That is why four is called the universal rhythm. All systems of music have four as the universal rhythm.
Sir, there is a question from one of the viewers. Her name is Charu, yeah. Hari Krishna Hariharan. Charu Hariharan. She,
yes,
asked,
sir,
the question somewhere in between. She her question is importance of korvais when you perform such compositions. I think it is yes.
Actually Charu is my, she is my student actually. It's okay,
yes,
Charu. I'm happy that you are here listening to my lecture. And I think probably annotations, this is the first program, no?
Yes, sir. Annotations, this is, okay, the first program. And
this is the,
yes,
first program. I'm very happy about it. Actually, I would like to do a separate program on Korvai. Probably,
okay,
our 50th annotations, I will do it.
Okay. Thank
because
you so
much. Korvai is a big topic. Korvai is a very,
yes,
big topic.
Yes.
Which cannot be,
yes,
said like a four universal rhythm. You cannot say that. So jati, develop the jati and follow the rules of the korvai, then we will be able to make the korvai. Basically, numbers also. I would like to tell them very simple. See, 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. 3 threes and 5 5. 4 threes and 4 5s will make a korvai. That is a sort of korvai. If you leave 1, 1, 3 and 1, 5, tak it, is a small korvai for six aksharas.
Okay, sir. This is again some sort of a layman kind of question. Now, all these jatis and jatis, especially the rhythmic pattern, has actually fallen into a very good pedagogy. As in, it's now a complete system of teaching, and there is a particular pattern to it. Were there some significant few individual contributors who did it, or was it? Of course, it will be a collective and a community contribution.
Yes.
But is there someone who did a great?
See, I tell you, there are schools. Pudukottai School and Tanjore School.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Pudukottai School has formed a basic set of lessons. And Tanjore schools have formed a basic set of lessons. And individual artists have improvised, developed, and they have also done a lot of work on teaching laya. And they have included as part of their teaching. So many value additions have come. So many improvisations have come. But I have developed a system recently called Kalpita Laya. It's not only for Mridangis, but it's for everyone who wants to learn Laya. Kalpita Laya is a concept that I have developed right from scratch till wherever the student wants to go. I told you patience, it requires patience. Unless the 1/4, 3/4 comes for all talas, they can't learn. And it is very difficult to learn in the initial stages. So they have to pass each of the stages to go through this rigors of learning laya. So Kalpita Laya is a holistic system, including all that has gone through in the past 120, 140 years of learning laya. I have probably, you can say, I have consolidated the entire thing. And I have also made a lot of inputs onto them. I have also made one more thing. Concert oriented, that is concert oriented laya, that is people who want to improvise them as swaras, improvise them as score wise, improvise them as korappu, improvise them as different arudis, tirmanams, and they the dance jatis, they can convert them into dance jatis. So all of them have been included in this full capsule. Depending on the student, it may take about 3 to 5 years to learn the entire thing, depending on the grasp of the student. So I wouldn't say it is my contribution. My contribution is compiling the entire thing and putting them value additions, making them into a logical order, systematizing them, the entire process of systematizing them, and then giving them. I'm slowly giving it to all my disciples, whoever is coming to learn from me, and also to my existing disciples. So there are various contributors. Yandaro Mahanubhavulu Andariki Vandam. What else I can say?
I know very well.
I'm always humble. I am a very small speck.
Sir, that's the humility side of you. Actually, you have seen it, and thank you so much, sir. Actually, Charu corrects herself. She says she wanted to know the importance of Karvai. I don't know. I'm just quoting her. Karvai. Maybe I misread it as Korvai. Yeah, it could be my mistake.
Sorry. Yes, yeah. Karvai is a gap. Karvai is a gap. I wanted to tell you that actually I forgot. One syllable you can develop into other jatis also. One jati, that is one set of one word. If you give a karvai, you can add numbers and give them into 10. That is from 5. Ta-di-di-ma-tum is the syllable for 5. Add one gap, it becomes 6. Ta-di-gi-na-tum. The same syllables are retained. Ta-di-gi-na-tum will be retained. But we keep on adding one syllable, and that is the karvai.
Okay.
The karvai, if you give a karvai appropriately, not anywhere else. Ta-di-gi-na-tum. We don't do it. That is the aesthetic sense I told you. It has got everything.
Okay.
Ta di gain natum. Ta di gi natum. We don't do it. Ta di gain natum is aesthetically good. And then add one more syllable to ta di gain natum, you get 7. Ta di gain natum. So we don't say ta di gi natum. We don't do it. Ta di gain natum. Then 8. Add one more. Ta di gain natum ta. That is 8. Tat Ding, ge, na, tumta. That is 9. All gaps, 5. All gaps ka. Di, ge, na, tum, ta. 10. That is the work of Karvai. You can add Karvai. Takka dimmi is ta tum ta. That is takka dimmi. So, ta takki tatta ta dim ta. That is also. The Karvai is extension of a syllabus.
Okay. Beautiful, sir. Thank you so much. Sir, probably we'll have to conclude now. Maybe since your lecture will be available offline, maybe there could be a few more questions which will come. I'll try to ask it personally to you and update the comment section with the responses.
Sure. No problem.
It was indeed a great evening for all of us. And thank you for starting off and giving us this inaugural lecture for annotations at Kalamshu. It was always a pleasure to have you, be it when you came to visit at Kalamshu long back and this time. We are really thankful for your this lecture, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kalamshu, for giving me this wonderful opportunity. I also got to meet a lot of people. I hope all of you like this lecture. And I hope you all continue to learn, Laya. I always tell my students, never stop learning. I am a learner. Even after 45 years of my performance, 40 years of my performance in learning and teaching, I am a humble learner. Anything you want to ask me, you can ask me anytime. If I don't know, I will learn and let you know. And I want to remain a learner always. I thank my gurus, my parents, my family, my wife and my children for all the support they have given me for learning this great art during my tenure. And I also would like to once again thank Kalamshu for this wonderful opportunity. I remain a student. Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Namaskaram.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. We wish to see you soon on Kalamshu platform again. Thank you so much. Let me just remind the viewers, tomorrow we are going to have footnotes at Kalamshu, where Kumari Shri Kripa and Kumari Anaga Prasad. Kumari Anaga Prasad is the disciple of Sushama Shreyas. She's from a dancer from New Jersey. And Kumari Shri Kripa Aital is the disciple of Vidushi Supriya Hari Prasad. Shri Kripa is also a disciple of Kalamshu. Tomorrow we have footnotes where these two young artists will be presenting Bharatanatyam recitals. Please join us at 1800 hours Indian Standard Time. Until then, goodbye. Thank you all of you for joining. Please do leave your comments and questions. We shall pass it on to the speaker and try to get his response about it. Thank you. Have a good evening.